Please welcome Mila Kunis, everybody. Mila Kunis. Lovely to see you.
You too.
You look very nice.
Thank you. I'm so excited to be here.
Really?
Yeah. Do I sound like I'm lying?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. Are you lying?
No, I am. I'm not, because I've never done your show.
No, you haven't.
I was wondering. You're the only show I'm still left to do, so I was really stoked to do it.
No, this is the only one you haven't done? Oh, well, thanks for getting us right up there with...
Well, you never invited me.
Oh, au contraire.
Oh, no. Listen,
I did. I did. I especially wanted you here tonight.
Oh, thank you.
Because this is jangly tights. These are fantastic.
You don't understand. I've been making fun of this outfit all day long.
Have you? Isn't the whole idea to find someone else to make fun of, don't you?
No, I'm really good at making fun of myself. Yo. I've perfected that art. No, I know. It looks... I'm looking at the thing. It looks really shiny.
No, they look good. They look like you could leave very quickly. No, you could just like boom, be out. It's good. And maybe if you were swimming in cold water, they'd be excellent.
Do you think they're like they'll give me speed underwater? Like, could I be a faster swimmer because of them?
I don't know how fast a swimmer are you just now.
Not very fast.
Well, you'll probably pick up a bit of speed with those babies on. Yeah. Yeah, no, you'll be good. Are you interested in doing triathlons, etc.?
No.
Me neither. I know.
You guys should do it together then.
What,
you
should do just a triathlon together?
Yeah, let's see how far we can get.
No.
What are the three things we have to do? What do you have to do?
You have to
swim,
run, and hop, I think.
I think I'm really good at hopping.
Really?
Yeah, I can.
Any particular leg, or do you just are you ambidextrous?
I'm really good at both. Yeah, no, I'm really good at like potato sack races.
Oh, nice.
You didn't know that about me.
No, I didn't. That wasn't on your Google page.
No. I'm really good at those.
Well, I tell you what was on your Google page though, is that you're Russian. Are you really Russian?
No, I lied.
You lied on your Google page?
I thought it'd be more interesting this way.
I like that. You don't sound Russian.
No?
And you don't have a moustache. So right there, I'm thinking.
Little do you know.
You are Russian?
Yes.
You really are Russian?
Yes.
But like properly born in Russia and then...
Came here in 91.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you must have been very young though, but like two or something?
I was just born.
Yeah,
I'm
right.
Really young. No. I was 7 and a half.
Oh, well, that is quite young.
Yeah.
Do you remember Russia?
I do vaguely. I mean, I remember parts of it, but I'm not sure how much of it is really my memory and how much of it I made into a memory through, like, my parents' stories and stuff.
I do that with movies.
Do you create movies?
Yeah, no. What happens is that I sometimes think it's my memory and I go, oh, wait, that's a movie. Like, no, like, sometimes I think, I was a debutant during
World War II?
During the Civil War.
Oh, okay.
And then I think, oh, no, that's Gone with the Wind. That's Scarlett O'Hara. That wasn't me. That wasn't me. I sometimes get confused.
Yeah, I understand. That happens. Yeah. That happens at your age.
And so it does. No, be fair. Be fair. Don't owe her. If we start owing the truth in this country, no, it's true.
You made fun of my pants.
No, I am. I'm not defending myself. I'm getting old. The laws of physics apply to me as anyone else. I gray hair here. Gray hair here.
Really? Already? Here. Okay.
Gray hair.
I know. I have gray hair here.
No,
yes.
I don't see any.
Oh, it's in there.
Really? What do you do? Tuck it around the other hair or something?
Underneath. I do. If you want to look and find it, it's up here. It's in the crown.
Oh. Do you really have gray hair?
I do.
Well, you'll have to dye then. That's what actresses do.
I like find them and pull them out. I know you're not supposed to do that.
No, you can't. If you do that, you have to walk around three times.
Was that in a movie?
No, that was in a movie. Listen, we have to take a break. Would you hang around?
Absolutely.
Probably for another couple hours?
Sure.
We'll be right back. Welcome back to
to the show. Tonight we're taking a good hard look at the modern Russia and the Soviet collapse of the Soviet Union with Mila Kunis. Mila, you yes. are you are Russian. And,
correct.
How's that then? I was trying to be quite newsy there. What
I was trying
think?
To come up with a really good answer, and I couldn't. I was trying to be very, like, correspondent-like, and I just nothing came out. I was like, uh-huh.
That happens to me nearly every night here.
Really?
Yes. I try and say funny things, and then I end up just going, and everything, and that's...
And then people just laugh anyways.
Well, it's because they're high. That's why.
Look at, they're all just giggling. Now, stop. Look at, there's one giggle over there. That's very, oh, see, that's just covering her mouth.
Don't. No, we'll have to pay them if we take shots of them.
They're great.
Do you ever go hang gliding?
Why are you inviting me out on a date?
Yeah.
I have to check my schedule.
That means no, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I've never been hang gliding anyway.
No, I've never
gone. Hang gliding.
I know what you meant.
Yeah.
No, I've never gone. I'm not very like adventurous. Although I do want to go skydiving one day.
That's quite adventurous.
Yeah, I want to try it, though I'm really scared. I don't understand why, how it's physically possible to jump out of a plane, to float in the air, and then to maybe shoot you. It just scares me, but I want to.
I've got a pilot's license. I could fly you up in the airplane.
No.
And then you could jump out. And then when I land, if you live, you can tell me how it was.
Do you know how awful of a flyer I am?
Really?
Yeah, I'm a really bad flyer.
But that's why I started to learn to fly, because I was terrified of flying.
I heard that's what you're supposed to do, is like teach, you become a pilot. And then
right.
No. I don't.
Why not? Why not? Why? Defend.
Why won't I get a pilot? Well, there's so many reasons for it. Where do I begin? I don't understand. Here's the truth. This might come out wrong, but okay. There's two things I don't understand. Have a drink.
All right.
I don't understand how. I took physics and I did really well. And
right.
I get the logistics of how a plane stays up in the air.
Yeah.
But I don't understand it. Like, I don't understand.
Well, then you didn't do really well in physics. You're living a lie, Mila.
No, here's the thing. I understand that, you know, it's from the bottom of the wings that holds it up. I get it. But there are no strings. I don't. It's not. No, it shouldn't be up in the air. I like being on the ground. Like I like.
I'm not
walking.
Against being on the ground, right? But I'm not saying, oh, all you people that live in the ground, you're bastards. You know. All I'm saying is, there's nothing wrong with flying.
Yeah, but no, but there is. It doesn't make sense. It just doesn't.
I tell you, what doesn't make sense to me. The Jonas Brothers don't make sense. Now. I'll tell you why I say this, because a lot of the kids watch me for tips.
Really?
Yeah. I make myself laugh at the idea of that. Hey, come on, Craig's on, let's watch him for tips. And how to be a middle-aged Scottish guy. But the I you know, people say, well, the Jonas Brothers, it's just like the Monkees or something like that, but it's not, because the Monkees were okay.
The Monkees.
Somebody.
Is that really true?
Yeah, somebody did.
Now I feel really left out. So
you got a cup over there.
But that's not. It's not a snake. So.
Okay. Well, this isn't a snake. It's just ceramics fashioned into kind of to look like
next
a snake.
Next time I'm bringing my own cup.
I think we might have a. Do we have an extra snake cup lying around? Oh, we don't. We give it away, do we?
I'm gonna make myself a cup at Color Me Mine and bring it.
You can't say Color Me Mine here. That
what?
Would be advertising Color Me Mine.
Oh, I won't make it at Color Me Mine. I'll make it at a place that is like Color Me Mine.
Oh, that's so lame. Yeah. Do you enjoy ceramics? Is that your idea?
I do.
Do you really?
I do. I actually...
Crafts? Yeah. Oh, right. Good.
Yeah, I am. I have a craft room. I do. I love doing things. I'm not necessarily good at everything I do, but I have a sewing machine and I taught myself how to sew.
Oh,
so I made kitchen curtains.
Wow.
Yeah. And then I made a dress, and then I...
Out of the same material as the kitchen curtains?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's okay.
The material was on sale, so it was just a lot of it.
Well, do you like the Project Runway? Project Runway, the show?
Yes, yes.
I love...
Hold on, should we talk about this? What? I love Project Runway.
Girl, you found a home, because I love Project Runway.
Okay.
I'm not kidding, I do.
Did you watch the All-Stars?
No.
Oh, my gosh.
No, I watched that. I've started watching the new season.
There was one episode. It was like an All-Stars episode where they got back all, like, the favorites.
You, excuse me a second.
Yes,
sorry.
What happened?
Joe, can you come? Look, there you go. We got a present for you right there. Right there. There you are.
Oh, I love
there
it.
There you are. Welcome, welcome to the West, my Soviet
Thanks.
Friend.
Oh, I love, look at
his nurse, come
Why
on.
Why is mine so little?
Yeah, well, you know, it's, you can't have too many of these lying around. That was specially made for me.
Yeah, yours looks evil, mine looks nice and petite. Just saying.
All right, so Project Runway, right?
Yeah.
So it started. They've started the new season in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Which I thought, oh, I'm a bit concerned, but no,
it's not bad.
It's good. It's
Do you want to hear a funny story about? Okay, so
it'll stick out in this show, but try it.
I've never nerded out on anybody. Like I've met really impressive people, and I'll say, and I've been very lucky with the people I've met, and I've always played it really cool. I was in New York a couple years ago at a small restaurant, and Daniel Vosovic was there, who didn't win Project Runway but should have.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about? Was like 2 seasons ago.
Yes.
Yeah.
So he was a couple tables away from me, and I was like, oh my God, I got so excited. I was like, I'm gonna play it cool, it's no big deal. So I finished eating, and I'm about to leave, and then something came over me, and I attacked him. I all of a sudden, like, I was standing there, and I turned around, and I was like, across the restaurant in New York City, he was like, oh my God, you should have won. And I started yelling at him. And he was so scared.
Were you a little,
No.
Oh, come on, a little bit?
I was sober is the sad part. I mean, it was afternoon. I was sober.
You famously enjoy a drink in the afternoon. Everybody knows that.
Let's not talk about that.
All right, yeah.
No, I was so, I just.
I know, I get very, so you know why I think that works and other reality shows don't work for me? Because Project Runway is about talent. It's about talent.
I agree
and
with you.
Skill. Yeah. It's not about how many babies can you have in a half hour. It's about a real thing, you know.
Do you watch Top Chef?
I've seen Top Chef.
I love Top Chef.
The trouble is with the Top Chef shows and the cooking shows for me is I watch them, I get hungry, I eat.
And I do. But it's like really great. You watch it and then you have dinner. It's like satisfying and fulfilling.
No, but I can't do that because
why?
Because I'll have dinner and then watch TV and then have another dinner. No, I have a very addictive personality, very suggestive.
Yeah. You know?
Really, yeah. I think we're doing pretty well, actually, aren't we?
I think so.
We're doing all right. So you've got your crafting.
Yeah.
And
sewing and crafting.
Sewing and crafting. It's very nice. You're a very girly girl, then.
I have girly tendencies. I'm very much a tomboy, but I'm still, you know, a girly girl, yeah.
Right. What? Oh, we have to talk about the movie. The movie looks very interesting, doesn't it? Extract. That
thing.
So what's going on in the movie then, Mila?
The movie's really funny, I have to say.
Is it? No,
yeah,
I believe you. You're
no,
in
no.
it. You're very good. You made
thank
me laugh
you,
in the Sarah
you.
Marshall movie and the 70 Show stuff. You're very, very
thank you, thank
talented.
You. I thought the movie was great. I love Mike Judge, and I was a huge fan of Office Space.
Right.
This is very much
the vein. Judge, he did The King of the Hill.
Yes, King of the Hill, Beavis and Butthead, Office Space, Idiocracy, and it's in the vein of Office Space. Really, really funny movie. You might relate. It's about a middle-aged man going through midlife crisis.
Hey. All right, yeah. A middle-aged man that what?
Going through like a midlife crisis. A cool, yeah, you know. Early midlife crisis.
No,
I
have mine a couple of times a month, really. It's an odd thing. You're still terribly young, but it's funny. You get older and you start doing really mad things. And you start to realize that by the time you're... You know old guys in the supermarket that say really dirty and rude things to the checkout girls?
Yeah.
I'm going to be one of those guys.
Yeah.
Because I'm starting to knock it. I'm like...
Already?
Yeah. I'm 47. I'm like, hey, look at you. Yeah, no. It's weird.
It starts early.
Yeah,
you know
with me it has anyway.
As long as you're aware, you're fine.
Really? You think so?
And, I mean, yeah. It's
you can say that even to the arresting officer?
Sure. Just like, I was aware, sir. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, listen, we're out of time.
Oh,
so,
really?
Yeah. Not only that, I've got some apologies to make to the second guest as well. but here's what I think we should do.
Okay.
I think you should come back.
Okay. Tomorrow?
Yeah, all right, yeah.
Okay.
As long as you don't mind actually doing the show.
Yeah.
Well, you do the show, I'll take the night off, and...
I'll just do, like, some skits
and
stuff.
Have a puppet go, oh, cheeky monkeys, nobody will notice.
Yeah, but do I have to have an accent?
No, you don't need an accent.
No accent. Then we'll just do it.
Make one up.
Okay. I'll just.
Well, you're Russian. Do that one.
I'll just do a really bad Russian accent.
Do you? Do you speak Russian?
Yes.
Oichim krasiva.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Daddy knows how he's working. Mila Kunis, good night, everyone. Please welcome the adorable Mila Kunis, everybody. Mila Kunis. All right. Why are you putting the microphone on yourself when you like the sound guy because he gets grabby?
Well, I have no place to put it. I mean, I do, but it would just be not very proper to put in that hole. It's the only place that you can stick it under the dress.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
In the dress? No, you're great. It's fine.
I guess I could do it on my ankle if I had to.
Yeah, you could wrap it around your... You could wear a little strap or a pack on your back or something.
Oh, I could. Yeah, up here. Yeah. The problem is it usually flips out.
What flips out?
The mic, it's a little packet.
Is it working all right now? It's pointing right at me.
Move over what?
Oh, you're rubbing your arm on it. See, look, you've...
I got frisky with the mic.
Yeah. I got my collar went nuts tonight as well.
I saw.
It's crazy. Why is my collar doing that? Is it because my neck's too fat or too thin?
No, but apparently you lost weight in your neck.
Yeah, I did. I lost 10 pounds in my neck.
Do you want to know what I learned about that, though? If your neck is half the size of your waist.
Really?
Yeah, it's if you are, I swear, this somebody just taught me this. If you want to know what size hips you are, hips, that's what it is. For jeans, just measure your neck and double it. So let's say you're 12 on your neck, you're a 24 jean.
Well, I'm 16 and a half on my neck.
So then there you go. Now double that and you know where you're going to be in your jeans.
That's 33. 33? Look, if I could count, I wouldn't be doing this crap, would I?
Oh, wait, I have a present for you.
No way!
Wait, hold on. I almost forgot. All right, so remember last time I was here, I stole this.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, no, you can have it. I gave it. You can keep it.
Wait, that's not my present. I'm keeping it. I just brought it up. This is for, like,
Well, you brought it back to let me see how it's
this
doing.
This is your present.
This for me?
Yeah.
You got it from Color Me Mine?
Well, I made it.
Did you make it?
Yes.
Oh, how lovely. This is very... Oh, wow. That's adorable. It says Craig's Cup on it. And then look, in the inside it says the end. And then on the back it's got an ass. It's lovely. And you didn't design that. You got the cup and then you just painted. You didn't make...
I designed the ass and the happy face.
It's nice. Yeah. I don't know what to do now. My other cup, because I've got two cups, and I'll keep this for. I'll transfer some stuff across then. Did you clean it first?
No. All
right. Can you hang on to this?
Yeah, I'll take it.
All right. Yeah, there you go. Nothing stupid looking about this at all. It's good. How have you been?
I'm good.
Yeah?
I'm good. Yeah,
it's all right. Do you go to Color Me Mine a lot?
Do
you go especially to make me a cup?
Yeah.
You did not.
I did because I took this one, so then I thought that it'd be funny to bring another one.
It's adorable.
You can have it be for all your guests. It could be their guest cup.
Well, it says Craig's Cup on it. Plus, I don't want people to have a cup with an ass on it.
It looks like a 10-year-old made it. Look at this. It looks so bad. I'm so sorry.
No, I think it looks good. I think the ass looks perfect.
This actually took me a while. Is that sad? It probably took me an hour and a half at Color Me Mine. Because I had to get the shoes. Oh, they look like Ronald McDonald's shoes.
You can't say that. Can't you say IHOP shoes or something?
I didn't say who Ronald McDonald was.
Well, that's true. Yeah, people in America have never really heard of Ronald McDonald, so it'll be all right.
Isn't he the most recognized person? Like, in a picture to kids, it's Ronald McDonald.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's like Ronald McDonald, and then it's Santa Claus, and then it's like Jesus or something. Yeah, Ronald McDonald, I think, is number one.
I can't talk about any of it. Maybe Santa Claus I could talk to you about for a little bit. Do you like Santa Claus? Do you believe in Santa Claus?
I love Santa Claus.
No, you don't.
Why not? Oh, I'm Jewish, but yeah.
Well...
I don't know if I believe in Santa Claus, but in Russia we used to have a character, but I guess if you translate it, it'd be like Mr. Frost?
Jack Frost.
Kind of, yeah. That
but
would
he
be,
brought presents.
He's the one who brought presents, but he brought presents on New Year's.
And let me guess, did he bring vodka?
Not to little kids. Like tangerines and bubblegum.
Tangerines, bubblegum, and vodka.
For the special kids. Yes.
Right, okay, yeah.
For the really good kids.
How have you been with the Eli book thing? The movie? I'm looking forward to this movie.
Are you?
Yes, I am, actually. Oh. I see the posters for it everywhere. It looks quite scary.
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's not scary. I mean, a little bleakish, but it's not super scary. It's a little, well, yeah.
So you're saying I shouldn't bother going to see
it
then?
No, I think you should.
I think you did. I think you said,
I'm going to get in so much trouble. I think you should. It's not scary. It's just, there's violence and action and drama, but it's not like scary.
I don't like any of these things in movie. I like a movie that has people talking to each other about their feelings.
What else do you like?
Yeah. People talking about their feelings, and in the end, we all kind of learn something. That's my type of movie.
That is Book of Eli.
That and boobies and explosions.
Boobies?
Boobies? Yeah.
Okay. There's boobies. Not my boobies, but boobies. No, not my boobies.
No, all right.
My boobies did not make an appearance.
What else have you been up to?
Ballet. Well, last time I was here, wasn't I training for ballet?
Yeah, you were.
Yeah, now I'm shooting the ballet.
You can do ballet?
I mean, I can fake doing ballet.
Is it a ballet dancing movie where a ballet dancer learns things from an old ballet dancer and then...
No, not even close.
All right.
No, not so much. It's like the downfall of a ballerina played by Natalie Portman, and I play her nemesis.
You're the evil ballerina?
I'm not that evil.
Oh, come on.
Come on, no. I'm not evil. Right. I am just maybe not the... No, I'm not evil. I'm just a different side of hers. Like, she's like the good and I'm the bad.
You're the evil ballerina, then.
Well, no, I don't know. No, I'm not evil. I don't do evil things.
Do you wear dark colored clothes in the movie?
Yes.
Yes, so you're the evil one. And she wears light colored clothes, so people who are stupid can go, what was an evil ballerina?
Yeah, she wears a lot of light colors.
That's how you can tell in movies. And if you watch a movie and someone coughs at
the start,
they're going to die.
Yeah, absolutely.
But they go, yeah. And somebody goes, are you all right? They go, I'm fine. Next scene.
It's very true.
It is?
Yeah. No one really coughs in this movie, so we're all fine.
How can you make a ballet movie where nobody coughs? It wouldn't be real.
That doesn't really even make any sense.
No, it does, because ballerinas all smoke.
They do. They smoke and they drink a lot of Diet Coke.
I used to do that.
Really? Smoke
well,
and drink Diet Coke?
It wasn't Diet Coke. It was whiskey.
It's good. It's a good lifestyle.
Yeah, it's all right. Yeah, you can end up here if you do that.
Are you happy you're here?
Yeah, I am actually right now. Are you watching all this TV? Oh, my Lord. What do you watch on the TV? What do you watch?
Jersey Shore. Currently? I heard you're a big Jersey Shore person.
No, I haven't seen it.
Everybody's
talking about it. I haven't seen it. It's something about angry people in Jersey or something, right?
Angry would not be the word I use, but they're different. I mean, they are different.
What? Different to
what? I
don't
understand how you don't watch the show.
There's
a guy named The Situation and a female named Snooki. That's all you need to know. She's like 4'7". She is tiny little
She could
thing.
Take over Denver. She could.
Yeah.
She could use her natural height advantage to get more oxygen and
She could.
Yeah.
She's amazing.
Is she, why, is she the star of the show, Snookies?
I mean, in my eyes, yes. I wait for her to make an appearance. The show, you can't even
It's a reality show. I mean, I'm aware of it. It's a reality show where people...
About people living in the Jersey Shore for the summer. It's like a vacation spot, I guess.
And do they get drunk a lot?
Yeah.
All right, yeah.
And they do really stupid things all the time. And they say the stupidest things. It's a brilliant show. Like, it is. You couldn't write it. I mean, I can't explain to you half the stuff that it
says. Do you care about any of these people? Do you watch the show?
All of them.
You do? You care about them?
Every single one of them. Absolutely.
Do you want to meet them? Do you want to be on the show?
I want to be them. I am enamored by these people. You just drink up.
Yeah.
I think they're...
Jeez, I'm falling apart
What's happened?
Don't worry about that. See, I'm not used to that. I'm used to this. But I wouldn't use this now.
You can use it. It's okay.
I'll use this. It'll be like when you get a present and somebody gives you a present then whenever they're
the only time
come to your
ever
house.
Bless
yeah,
house
so whenever
when
you're
show.
On the show, I'll be using this cup.
I can't even look at you right
Why,
now.
What is wrong with that? I think you show great talent. And, you know what, actually? This would be awesome in Adult Swim on the comedy. Like a little stoner cup.
Dude, I love you. Hey.
He's got one ear. I'm going to call him Vincent.
That's perfect.
Yeah, it is. He's got one ear right here.
I'll Vincent the cup.
Yeah, Vincent.
He could be on the Jersey Shore.
He could. Now, the people on the Jersey, aren't the Italian-American groups angry about this show, though?
Yeah, I suppose. I mean, I would be if I was Italian.
Yeah?
I would. They are a very interesting representation of that culture.
Yep. But it's not really that culture, though. It's just stupid young people getting drunk
it's
and wearing
exactly
Ed Hardy,
that,
isn't
yes.
it? Yeah.
Do you know what I am obsessed with?
Sex.
Wait. Oh, wait. My parents are watching.
Oh, sorry. You're obsessed with your parents? What are you obsessed with? What are you obsessed with?
So, over the weekend, we were doing the junket at a hotel, and they had these toilets. I wish I knew the name of the toilet, because I would want to be the spokesperson for this toilet. It is truly an amazing piece of art. It washes and dries you while you're...
I've seen this toilet.
I
encountered this toilet in
Japan.
In Las Vegas. But
yeah,
it was. I said, "Where did you get this toilet?" And they said, "It comes from Japan."
Yeah,
and it does. It takes care of everything.
It's $10,000. It's a $10,000 toilet.
Yeah, but I mean,
want it.
You just you get in there, it unbuckles your pants.
Yes!
It does the lot. Yeah.
And it puts the toilet seat up or down, and depending if you're male or female, it will put the, you know, the top part down
it
versus... You just press buttons.
Yeah, you just walk in and just,
yeah.
You know, you could be reading a paper and...
It'll flip the page for you.
Yeah, yeah. But my son went in, right? He's eight and a half, and he went into the toilet, and I thought, I hadn't seen it yet, so he goes in, and I hear all this. And then he came out, and his face was ashen, and he went, "What the hell was that? I am never going in there again." He was really freaked out
by
it.
Yeah,
and I went in and I came out and do the same thing. I'm like, oh, wow.
Yeah, I'm obsessed with this toilet.
It's very, I don't think it'll catch on, though.
You don't?
No, $10,000 for a toilet.
No, I know, but that's why someone needs to come out with, like, cheaper version of it, and then, you know, due to the competition, they will have to lower the prices and then send me one because I'm doing promotion for it.
Look, I'm not your agent, but surely you're doing pretty well right now. You don't need to be...
I can't...
I'm Mila Kunis, and I'm a spokesman for really good toilets.
These are the things that I need. I mean, I would want this toilet.
Yeah, you must be making a little money. You buy one.
I am, but I'm not going to go and spend $10,000 on a toilet.
No, who is?
I was not raised to be.
Well, now you're not promoting them, because now they're like...
Oh, I mean, no, I think they're great.
You can't. No. That's it. Hey, we're out of time.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah. Right. You can go and use our $40 toilet now if you want.
Thanks.
That was a very nice thing to say, wasn't it? I'm sorry.
This interview's just all going down the toilet.
Yeah, it was just...
See, it all comes around full circle.
Yeah, no, it did. It kind of came full circle, yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah.
A teeny bit.
I like the awkward pause at the end, if you wouldn't mind.
I enjoy it.
Yeah.
Watching it backstage, and I hadn't seen it in forever, and I realized how bony my chest was. It looked disgusting.
No, it looked fine, but I'm glad to see it back to its normal self.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, no, it's good. It's lovely to see. Oh,
uh-oh.
Hang on. Sorry. Did I swear there? You have to beep that? Well, I might as well just say,
hi, caramba.
Then.
Hi, Australia.
I was just going to get a drink.
Oh, my God.
See, because the last time you were here, you got me this cup, and I use it every night. Sometimes I use this cup, but most of the time I use this cup.
Why are you lying to me?
I'm lying to you.
Come on, look, you got a pretty little butt. Did you see this? Look, I drew this. I made this. I color me mine.
Yeah.
All by myself. Artist. Okay.
Yeah, you'll get an Oscar for the movie, but you're getting bugger all for your cup work. The movie's doing great, though, isn't it?
Yeah, right?
No, it's fantastic. So yeah, everybody's saying that you're going to get an Oscar for it. Well, I'm saying it.
Who is this everybody?
Me, I say it. And this is how it starts. It starts with me, and it ends with, I'd like to thank the Academy. You know, and you, is it going out in Australia?
I don't know. Maybe?
Yeah, I bet. Oh, it is?
Is it?
It's opening Friday in Australia?
Hi, wow, Australia.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Who knew?
You ever been to Australia?
No.
Oh, it's awesome.
I got close. I've been in Fiji.
Oh, that's a completely different thing.
It's close.
No, that's like saying I've been to America. Have you really? Well, I was in Canada.
It's close.
It is quite close, yeah, I guess. Yeah. But it's not that. It's actually further away.
It is. No, I've never been to Australia.
It's nice. If you ever go, look out for these. I drew a little face on them.
Do I get a tattoo? Yeah. They're testicles. Can I say testicles?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you can say
they're balls.
Balls. Yeah. Yeah, you can. Yeah.
This looks so like a happy set of
balls.
Yeah.
Have you been otherwise? What are you up to? Are you making films? Are you doing the, what's going on?
What am I doing?
Yeah. Have you been on any road trips? You ever knock off any liquor stores and go on a crime spree or anything?
I jumped out of a plane.
No way!
I did.
Shut up!
I did.
How did you survive?
I had a big man strapped to my back that, you know.
Broke your fall?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, you went skydiving?
Yeah, I went skydiving. I want to go again. I think I'm going to go probably at the end of this month.
Did they let you do that if you're making a film? Did they say,
no.
Go and enjoy
Legally,
yourself?
I'm not supposed to.
No.
But I did. I went in the middle of a production. I can say it now because I finished the production, but I did it in the middle of August. On my birthday, I jumped out of a plane, and really? I was shooting Friends with Benefits at the time.
What's Friends with Benefits? Is that going out in Australia?
I'm pretty sure that one's probably going to hit Australia, yeah.
Yeah. Can you do an Australian accent?
July.
Can you do that?
No. No! Are you crazy? I barely do an American accent.
Try it.
No.
You try. Try it. Just go. Say after me. A dingo stole my bike.
Okay, here we go. Okay, right. Do it again. Okay, here we go.
All right.
Okay, go.
A dingo. Stole my baby. What's interesting is that on our first show in Australia, we'll piss off the entire country.
This is amazing.
I feel bad about it.
It's my favorite show ever.
What is?
Your show.
Oh, no, mine's is The Wire.
Okay, well, mine's Dexter, then.
Dexter? Do you like Dexter? It's about the serial killer,
right? I love Dexter.
Do you like serial killers? Are you attracted to serial killers?
A little bit.
Really?
Is that weird?
Do you like the...
He's like a vigilante serial killer.
What's the Silence of the Lambs? You know,
I thought you were doing like a T-Rex. I'm not sure.
Well, he kind of does that in the movie, doesn't he? He
goes
like
that. Oh, with
the
little arms? Yeah. I don't know about that.
Put the lotion in the basket. Put the lotion in the basket.
Twice
now. Fruits. You can beep as much as you want. Do you read books about serial killers?
No, I don't read.
A lot?
No,
you don't read?
I'm kidding. I just thought it'd be funny to say.
Well, it has place on this show then, young lady.
No, I read, but no, I don't read books about serial killers. I just watch Dexter. Oh, and like the network ID, did anybody watch it? No? Maybe somebody, a lady, hey now. So it's a show all about serial killers.
Do that thing with your ring again you were doing right there.
I fidget. What did I do?
You were doing that.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
You?
Jeff won.
I had to go.
Jeff, get in line.
Ooh, tell me more.
Yeah, shut up. No, that must be a kind of a Freudian thing.
Or I just fidget. I fidget.
There is no fidgeting.
You think this is Freudian?
Maybe.
Do you think this is Freudian?
Do you want to wear? Do you not fidget with your rings?
I do a little bit. I fidget with my wedding ring and then I have this other ring.
What about
that
here. One? What's that ring?
That's my family crest. Right there.
I want a family crest. I don't think my family was crested.
I don't think. The Kunis, they
are so well known, right?
Yeah.
For what?
Well, I don't know. Where are they originally from? Russia, right?
Chernivtsi, Ukraine.
The Ukraine?
Yeah, I don't know if we crested people. What, with like our wheat farms? Like, what were we crested for?
Well, maybe you can get a little wheat farm or something on your ring.
All right, is that really your family crest?
Yeah, right there. Look,
it's really pretty.
Yeah, and then there's a little, look at that. Isn't that great?
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting.
Oh, you know what I didn't do tonight is the emails. Yeah. I didn't do them. Do you want to do them?
What are they? Well, you what?
Well, you know this.
Sure.
You know, when they do the tweets and the emails, the people send them in.
What are your emails? Do you tweet?
Yeah, do you?
No.
Why not?
Because it frightens me. It does. I
Why?
Think it's
like serial killer frightens you, or just less.
No,
than
I just
that?
Don't think people need to know when I'm going to the restroom. What am I going to tweet? Like, hey, I'm now moving from room to room. I don't really know what I would tweet people. What do you tweet people?
I would like to know when you're moving.
I guess, I mean, it makes sense, but no, I do not tweet. But go
on. All right, then. Well, listen, we have to play the jingle first, or else. Oh, well, I'll just do the jingle. I'm sick of the jingle. All right, are you ready?
Go.
Tweets and emails. All right. Are you ready?
Yeah, go.
This is for a dear Craig and Mila. That's amazing. Oh, they knew you.
It's amazing.
My friend complained about getting a loofah for a gift. I said I liked them, and he made fun of me for it. Guys can't use loofahs?
Oh, with a question mark? Yeah. Loofahs?
Yeah.
I think guys can use loofahs.
Can they?
Why not? You got a scrub. What's so wrong with a loofah?
In your pants.
I guess.
Next.
All right, this is from Juan in Cordoba in Argentina. Argentina. You ever been to Argentina?
I have.
Have you really? I'd love to go
there. Argentina and Brazil.
Really?
Uh-huh. I was really young, though.
Really?
I was 15 maybe or 16.
What were you doing there?
We did a press tour, first year of 70s.
You were only 15 when you started that show?
I was 14 when I started that show.
Oh, boy, really?
Yeah, that was 13 years ago. Do you want me to do my finger gag one more time for you?
No.
Okay.
No.
I didn't think so.
I feel bad.
14.
Yeah. Well, here's one, young lady. This is from Juan in Cordoba in Argentina who says, I feel creepy. Dear Craig, what kind of bird will they put on my Twitter? I hope it's not an owl. I hate owls. See, we put, there's an owl. Do you like owls?
I don't dislike owls.
Do you like Harry Potter?
I do love Harry Potter.
You know, I never liked it. Well, at first, because I didn't know anything about it, I tend to approach everything with contempt.
Yeah.
And then I read them for my son.
Yeah.
And I love them.
They're great.
They're really good.
I know.
Because in the movies, I'm like, yeah.
But even the movies are great for what they are. But the books are really, truly well written.
Yeah, they are fantastic.
Yeah.
And he's got an owl.
Yes.
That's why they're not popular in Argentina.
Who knew?
Me.
Oh, okay.
All right, this is from April in Long Neck in Delaware.
Yeah.
Do you have a long neck?
I don't think
so. Pretty long neck. You could play a ballet dancer in a movie.
I was 20 pounds lighter. My neck was a little bit smaller at that point.
Do you carry weight on your neck?
You do. Do you know a trick is to measure your waist, to know what jean size you want to wear, ladies. Measure your neck and double it. And that'll be your waist size. If you're like a 24.
Why don't you just measure your waist?
I didn't think about that.
You just go right ahead. You got the tape right there. You're there. The tape's there.
I don't know. In case you can't measure your waist, measure your neck, and then double it.
All over Australia, women are going, that's great, isn't it? We really appreciate this. All right. April in Long Neck says, hey, Craig. And Mila, have you ever had a conversation on the phone with someone and then realized it wasn't the person you thought?
All the time.
Really?
Yeah. It happened 2 days ago.
When they booked you for the show and you thought it was the Tonight Show?
Maybe.
Kinda. Sure, I'll be there. Oh, dope. Why?
My phone scrambled all my phone numbers. when I connected my iPhone to my computer, I did something wrong where it literally re-scrambled my numbers, where I put like my grandmother's number under my friend. It was like a complete mess.
That's like a great plot for a movie.
No, it's not.
This is from Leslie in Tampa in Florida, all right?
Why does Leslie have a duck?
Well, this, which is she, I guess we were going to put an owl, but we used it on the other guy. She said, hey, Craig, I'm being dragged to a fortune teller by my co-worker. Have you ever been to a fortune teller? Have you ever been to a fortune teller?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
What did they tell you?
I can't remember, because I think I was a little bit hoo-hoo intoxicated. But it was in New York, and there's a really great little restaurant on the lower east side. And upstairs is a little fortune teller lady who's been there for, like, I don't know, 15 years. But I don't remember what the restaurant's called, otherwise I would plug it. But it's a really funny. Okay, next email.
No! I'm interested. Are you concerned about your future? Because you're going to do very well. You're going to win an Oscar for this movie. Everything's going to be awesome. Then you can measure your neck twice, add that together.
I don't remember what she said, honestly. I think it was all fine. I think it was like, ooh, everything's great. Like, I don't know if it was very
I think what they probably try and do, this is what they try and do, the unscrupulous fortune tellers, of which there are very few.
Yeah.
But what they try and do is they say, oh, you've got a curse on you, you have to come back.
A curse?
Yeah, a curse, you know.
Who has curses nowadays?
A curse, you know, like a gypsy curse.
Well, okay, my fortune teller didn't tell me I had a curse.
Well, maybe your fortune teller should have.
Okay. Go on.
Maybe I'm trying to tell you that I am psychic. I can tell you I'm a person. No, you don't. You're going to be fine.
Do you ever watch The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills?
I do. Oh, man.
Do
talk about a curse. I know. God, it's terrible, isn't it? But great, but
it's
terrible.
It's amazing. I mean, it's amazing.
That woman who's just a lip and shoes.
But she's so sweet, and she loves her
sweet,
daughter.
But I don't know if she's sweet or she just kind of looks like that. Oh,
but wait, did you see the episode where they were all at dinner at Camille's house and
yes.
Camille brought her friend?
The fortune teller. Who's told my... That fortune teller has told my fortune. Really?
What?
She was on the show, yeah, her name...
Is this real?
I swear this
okay,
is true.
Okay, go ahead.
Right, Alison Dubois is her
yes.
name, right? And when I started on the show, she was one of the guests.
Yes, but...
Yeah, right?
Okay.
It was at the beginning. and she was like... She was one of the guests, and she came on. I don't want to say bad things about her because she could.
No, of course.
Her.
No. I think she's great.
Yeah, no.
I don't want to be cursed.
No, you don't want that.
No.
You could do that. You look at my tattoo.
I did. I didn't know you had a tattoo.
Yeah, I got a tattoo.
I always
right?
wanted a tattoo.
Yeah, you can have one.
Okay, but wait. Tell me
all
the
right.
story.
So she was on here, and they said, well, do you want her? She offered to read my fortune, not on camera, for the, you know, just because she was going to be on the show, and I said, all right, and we went to this hotel and she read my fortune.
And? Was it like...
I can't really remember.
Hmm.
No, she said a lot of things.
That were spot on?
Well, yeah, but she could have Wikipedia'd me. So I don't know. No, she seemed to be quite genuine. But I saw her on the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills.
I know.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah, well, then that happened.
Is that going to happen to you when you get older? Are you going to become one of them trashy old drunk broads with plastic surgery?
Let me say it here and now.
Yeah?
No.
Well, when you say that now, but what happens later on when you develop alcoholism and a love for plastic surgery?
Well, I hope you're there for me and you will save me.
I will.
Okay.
Yeah.
I really hope that doesn't happen.
It won't happen. You'll be fine. But you have to make plans for how you're going to grow old. I didn't, and look what happened to me. Oh, yeah, I wanted to do 12:30 on CBS. That was my big dream. No, I'm serious. You got to make plans.
What? I'm only 27.
TikTok, girlfriend.
I'm screwed.
Nah, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. It'd be great. We're out of time.
That's it?
Yeah.
Why does it go by so fast?
If I could tell you the amount of time women have said that to me. Unbelievable. Mouth organ or awkward pause?
Hmm?
Mouth organ or awkward pause?
Awkward pause.
Really?
Yeah.
You surprised me.
Interesting. You thought...
I thought mouth organ.
All right, give me mouth organ.
All right, then I'll give you mouth organ. But first, here's the harmonica.
Okay. You know, my dad watches
it. It was a joke. I didn't mean it. It was a joke. It was stupid. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be too crass. It's a stupid joke. I'm sorry, Mr. Kunis.
Okay. Here we go.
All right. Take your time. Take your time.
Okay,
you don't just rush in there blowing and sucking and chewing. Take your time.
Craig!
I'm telling you how to play the harmonica.
Oh, my God.
No, no, no. All right, ready?
No.
We're going to do a nice... I'd like to do Waltzing Matilda for our new Australian viewers. All right? Everybody.
Necropolis. Locals call it the City of the Dead. So let's have fun with Craig and Mila Kunis.
Have we started? Okay, go. All right, ready?
Yeah, go. Yeah.
All right. Have you ever seen a dead body?
Yes, in photos. Does that count?
No, I mean close up. Have you ever poked one with a stick?
No. Wait, have you?
No.
Oh.
No, I would.
That would have been weird.
But I think, would you ever go to graveyards and think, life is so fleeting, and you should,
I guess so.
And you should do things, with wild abandon.
I probably should. I kind of go to them this is creepy. I wonder if zombies will pop out.
Do you think zombies would come? Would you come here at night?
Yes.
Really? On your own?
But I'm a little twisted. I also like to go see movies at cemeteries in LA, so...
Yeah, but that's with about 500 other hipsters. I'm talking here on your own with no hipster friends and no maybe little cigarettes.
I don't know what you're talking about.
But actually coming up here on your own without any sandwiches or anything to keep warm.
Can I bring a taser with me?
No.
Oh. A knife?
What good is a knife going to be? Look at that, look.
There's a person running.
Yeah.
Get her.
Look at that.
Where do you think she's going?
She's on the phone.
She's on a mission, you guys. Welcome to Scotland, everybody.
Yeah, look. Right, so come up here. I want to show you the grave of some famous Scottish people. Don't skip in the graveyard. That's sinful.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You'll be haunted.
Will I, though? Will I?
Would you believe in ghosts?
I don't know. Yes and no. I haven't seen one, so I don't know. Have you seen a ghost?
No, but the look at all these people there who are in the shop. I think you should all go over there. It's good to watch. All right.
So people don't get buried in the cemetery anymore, correct?
Not anymore, I don't think. I think now people get cremated. What are you going to have done when you die?
I think it all depends. If I die a horribly tragic death, cremate me.
Right.
But if I die okay and someone intact...
What do you mean die okay? What does die okay mean?
If I'm not all disfigured...
If you look good?
If I look all right.
You look good
fixable.
Now.
No, I appreciate it.
No, you do. No, but you look great.
Well,
I'm just saying, I'm just adding that to the... You look great. You look sensational.
Thanks. It's only 9 a.m.
I didn't want to come up here at dark time.
No, because then that would be scary, because you won't let me bring a taser or a knife, and then we can die.
Well, I don't know how you think a knife or a taser is going to protect you against the undead.
I'll poke them and run away.
No, that's not how it works.
It works. What books have you been reading?
Twilight books.
I don't read that.
You don't?
No.
Maybe a little bit?
No, I can honestly say I've never even opened that book.
Really?
No.
What about...
I tried... a friend of mine's daughter was reading it.
Yeah? What about Harry Potter? Did you read Harry
Potter?
Yeah,
I read all of those.
Oh, you did?
Those were actually really well-written
Let's go
books.
This way. Yeah, they're good. I want to go over to that monument there.
That big one?
Yeah. I want to tell you about that guy, because he's very important.
Do you know
Try not to walk over people's graves.
Why? I can't help it.
Okay.
Should we not dance on them either?
Don't dance on them.
Can I skip?
No, don't
Can
skip
do
or dance. Don't skip or dance or do cartwheels. It's very disrespectful. That's bad. I thought you were Russian.
Yeah, that's why I do it.
Oh, why?
I break the law. I'm rebellious.
No, that's I thought Russians had a great respect for misery.
So much so, we like to skip around.
I know.
This, oh my God.
Yeah. Do you know this? Who this is about? This is a monument to someone called John Knox. John Knox was the founder of the Church of Scotland, and he wrote a book. He wrote a book called That First Blast of the Trumpet Against That Monstrous Regiment of Women. Didn't like women.
Not at all.
And then his second book, you know what that was called? The Second Blast of the Trumpet. It's true.
Is it really true?
Yeah. He really, he wasn't.
Was he married?
I don't know. Yeah, probably.
Or was he a bachelor?
What, are you implying something?
I'm just asking.
No.
I don't want to offend a lot of Scots.
No. It's all right. I mean, he was married, I think. He
really?
Was, yeah, I think so. And he lived in Edinburgh.
Oh.
But they got his thing here. I don't know.
This is massive. I mean, it's truly massive.
I don't think he's buried here or anything.
It's just a monument.
That was the actual size of him, though. That's why people were so taken with him. He was like 50
feet tall. Like Paul Bunyan over here.
Yeah, he was great. And he used to go and plant trees. Is that Paul Bunyan?
No, that was maybe Johnny Appleseed.
I don't know. We're both immigrants. I don't know,
like, American folklore.
No, I don't either. Like, what's the one where Charlie Brown saves Christmas?
Yes, Charlie Brown likes to save Christmas from the Grinch.
Well, why does that happen?
It just happens that way. The Grinch stole it, and
Charlie Brown gets it.
Yeah, Linus, Lucy, Charlie all went in there, and it's the infinite story of how they stole Christmas back. Oof, that was rough.
Yeah, it's bad.
Yeah.
Hey, like, do you ever think about death? Like, what do you think happens after you die?
You die.
Yeah, well, I know you die. You don't die again.
You stop breathing.
Well, yeah, I know the physical, but what about the metaphysical? What do you think happens to your thoughts and your
Do you believe in God?
Yeah, I think I do. What about you?
I don't know.
I think I don't know is a better answer.
I don't know. I can honestly say I don't know.
Yeah.
I think I believe in something. I don't think that we are the center of the universe.
No, I don't think that either.
I can't tell you about the second coming of Christ or Jesus.
You don't know anything about that.
But maybe there's something out there. There has to be.
I think that...
But I don't know if you ascend up or down. I don't know if I believe in, like, you go up in the clouds if you go to heaven or you go down, you know. That I don't believe.
I have a hard time believing that if someone's big enough to create the entire universe, he'd be concerned about what food you ate and what day.
Yeah.
That's not really a big picture guy. Right,
I wouldn't think so. I think he'd have... bigger things to worry about.
Yeah. What about country music? Do you like country music? You don't? Because there's that song, From a Distance. That's a country song. You know what I'm talking about,
right? I do. I like when you sing it, though.
Oh, you do? Do you like my singing?
I do.
Oh, what do you want me to sing? Ask me to sing. I'll sing anything. We're in a graveyard. There's nobody here.
How about George Michael, Faith?
No, I don't want to sing any George Michael things in a deserted graveyard.
But you have to have faith.
Well, yeah, but I don't want to sing a George Michael song in a deserted graveyard because it kind of looks like I'm trawling for anonymous sex with strangers.
But you are, just with a camera crew and a whole lot of people.
No, I'm not. Is this your first time in Glasgow?
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
Drink beer and eat fish and chips.
You fit right in.
I feel like I'm doing really good so far.
Yeah, no, you're doing great.
It's a little bit chilly, I have to say. But it's
chillier
beautiful.
Than Russia?
Not Russia during wintertime. Yeah. But I have also...
You cold?
No, I'm all right.
You sure you don't want to cuddle?
Do you want to snuggle?
Yeah, come on. Snuggle for me in the cold. Yeah, John Knox will love this. He'll love you and me snuggle.
How mad do you think he is right now?
Pretty angry.
Right?
Yeah, but he was angry before we got here. So it's okay. This is great. You guys
so nice. Cool. Thank you.
Yeah, all right, get out. Go on.
Glasgow, Scotland, where my first guest tonight is the adorable, the talented, the sexy, the American, Mila Kunis, everybody, Mila Kunis. Oh, yeah! Come sit down. Welcome, Mila.
Wow.
Nice. You look great.
Oh, well, thanks. I didn't change. I saw you earlier.
You didn't see me earlier. This is the first time we met since we've been in Scotland. Did you see Jet?
Look, I see him. He's like, no.
How are you? You're enjoying Scotland?
Good. I am.
You were going to go and buy a kilt.
I was, and then I was told that we're going to go buy one in Edinburgh, so then...
Don't mention Edinburgh here.
Oh.
Wait, she didn't know! Give her a second chance!
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, no, that's all right. Have you ever been to Scotland before?
No.
It's nice, isn't it?
It's so nice.
Aren't the people lovely?
People are great. It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's easy to walk around. It's easy to get around. Yes. The food is actually kind of delicious.
No, you've gone too far. You've gone too far. We were right with you. Right up until you went, the food
I'm
is
not good. Saying that I think that people should eat haggis all day long, but the fish and chips are great.
Fish and chips are very good.
Yeah, yeah.
As long as you say, if you say their food is delicious and that haggis isn't that good, they'll be fine.
Wow.
But haggis is very. Haggis is like sausage.
It's not sausage.
Yes.
No.
No.
It smells funny. No, it's not sausage. Hold on. Sausage is like. Isn't haggis like a sheep intestine stuffed with like leftovers?
Yes. What is a sausage?
Things I don't want to know about.
Right. Well.
I'd rather just eat sausage because I'm gonna be ignorant and not know what goes in it. But I know what goes into haggis, and it's really gross.
Well, but the only difference between haggis and a sausage is honesty. Honesty. All right. Are you gonna go and see anything exciting? Are you gonna go and see Edinburgh Castle? Everyone goes there.
Yes.
Did somebody just hiss Edinburgh Castle?
Yeah. Yeah.
Part of Scotland.
What's the history? Why do they hate each other?
Well, Glasgow and Edinburgh are kind of like, it's a little kind of Boston, New York. It's kind of Yankee right. Sox thing. What?
Did you say you're. I thought she said her ass
know, she
is
said
bigger,
something
but I'm pretty sure that's not what she said.
What did she say?
Our ass is bigger, but
our
I know
ass
that.
Was
I'm sorry. Our ass is bigger. Yeah. I have no idea what she said. I don't understand the accent anymore, but I think they're getting more drunk. Do you have trouble with the accent here?
No.
Really?
No. Well, my family have accents, so it's not like the craziest thing.
They have Glasgow accents?
No, but you know, an accent's an accent, it's fine.
They're not all the same. That's a ridiculous thing to say. You say an accent's an accent.
I think once you have an ear for hearing funny things constantly, it doesn't sound that crazy. Honestly, come on now. No?
I think you just insulted everybody in the room. So, are you going anywhere else after Scotland? Are you going to go over to Russia and see family or anything?
No.
But what are you going to do? Are you just going straight back to America?
Yeah, well, I was in Paris last weekend.
Oh, Paris is lovely.
It was really nice.
Except there's French people there. I did notice that. Did you notice that?
Those French people, I ignored them. I just, right. I focused on Paris.
When you ignore the French people and then they say, why are you ignoring us? You can say, well, you started it.
Why do they sound like they're German?
Was that? You think my French accent sounds German?
A little bit.
Well, that very nearly happened. Oh, sorry. I nearly drank your...
I know.
But I don't want to catch your sore throat. Don't do that.
Are you drunk?
I don't know what to say. I think that woman thinks that coughing on someone is a sign of courtship in Scotland.
What if that's
how... You go up to someone in an elevator, and if you find them attractive, you go...
Ooh, hey.
Yeah,
hey.
You liked that, didn't you? Right, we're out of time. So what do you want? You want an awkward pause, a mouth organ, or a big cash prize?
Big cash prize.
All right. What time is it, Shadow Stevens?
It's time for the big Scottish prize.
Scottish prize. That was awesome there for the Scottish audience joined in. Not really. All right, look at that. £50.
Yeah.
£50 in pound coins in a bag with a pound sign on it, like the burglars actually use over
with
here.
With the dollar sign.
No. But here they use a pound sign. Yeah. Like burglars will come into your house and leave like this.
That's not very threatening. It's a very small.
That's for you. Feel the weight of that.
Oh, that's a lie.
Yeah.
Thanks. No, I'm kidding.
No, you got to answer the question. Well, there's two ways to win. You can actually answer the question, or you can guess what's in my box. Here's how this works. I imagine something that's in my head in a box, but I don't know what's in the box. Only Jeff knows what's in the box. And then if you get it right, that's great. And if you get it wrong, I hit you with this.
What? Okay, deal. Fine. Great.
Iceland is in the North Atlantic. Its capital city is Reykjavik. Which is of the following is not a famous Scottish soccer team?
Right? Oh.
Not.
Not a famous... Okay, go ahead.
A... Partick Thistle. Shut up. B. Dumbarton. C. The Dundee Rogues.
We go with that one.
It's a trick question. None of these teams is a famous Scottish soccer team. But they'll know the Dundee Rogues.
The Dundee Rogues.
Dundee Rogues. 50 Scottish fans. Mila Kunis.
The show.
Okay.
Do this. It's the start of the show, like a travel show. Welcome to Glasgow and stuff.
Okay, ready? Hold on.
Yeah. But you have to make a big deal about it.
What? Yes. Hold on.
Okay.
Hi. My name is Mila Kunis.
Welcome to Glasgow.
What the hell is this?
Haggis.
Oh, it's too depressing.
A bit of pizzazz to it.
Okay,
it's meant to be it's like, welcome to Glasgow. What a great, I'm very happy to be here.
Okay, here we
All right, go.
Hi.
That's exactly the same.
Okay, I'm sorry. One more time.
All right, I'll do it. I'll show you.
Go.
Stay right there. You stay there and wait there, and then I'll walk up. You ready?
Okay.
All right. Here we go.
Hi. I'm Mila Kunis. Welcome to Glasgow. We have so many things for you to see. We'll be right back.
Mila Kunis, welcome back. We're now in Edinburgh, where Craig's about to treat the lovely Mila Kunis to drinks, laughs, and a good time. Well, maybe just drinks.
You know why I order those little small cups like this?
To make yourself seem big.
Yeah, make my hand look huge. Look
They're
at that.
They're huge.
Right, so now what do you think when you look at my hand? You're like, look at the size of his hands.
He must have big gloves.
Well, I need them for all that. You doing all right?
It's fantastic.
Do you know why this pub is called Deacon Brodie's? You do? All right, tell me the story then.
I think I do.
All right, you tell me and I'll tell you if it's right.
I might have made this up.
Okay.
It has something to do with Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde.
Okay.
That Deacon used to be he was a prominent tailor or carpenter or something of that sort.
Mm-hmm.
During the day, but then at nighttime, he would go and rob people for his gambling habit. And then he was hung somewhere in this vicinity. Am I at all close?
It's pretty close.
Oh.
A deacon is a magistrate.
Yeah.
Right? So the magistrate Brodie was this guy you were talking about,
uh-huh.
right? And he would, during the day, he was very tough on criminals. He would say criminals are bad, and he would send them to the gallows, and he would be very naughty with them. And then at night, he would go out and be a criminal himself.
Yeah, and then...
And he got caught, and he got hung.
Did he get hung here?
In this very bar, at this table. They hung him from there. See that kind of hook thing there?
That's where he was.
That's right.
From.
And when, on a dark night, when you sit at this table,
yeah,
you can still hear him going... Do you believe in ghosts?
I feel like we've talked about it. I guess I do.
I'm asking you again.
Yeah.
Because I'm checking.
I don't know if I do, if I don't. I like to believe in it because it's fun.
Have you felt any presence in Edinburgh since you've been here?
I have to say, I haven't necessarily felt a presence, but our hotel has an insane draft. So you hear like a... Like this weird sound anytime a door opens on the opposite side of the room,
mm-hmm.
it's an insane crickety sound.
No, that crickety sound, that is the ghost of Deacon Brodie, who had a crickety leg. He had a tiny little crickety leg.
Why didn't they think that?
He had one little crickety leg and a giant, thick, powerful leg that he used to compensate, and he always walked in circles.
Around himself.
Yeah, he would walk in circles. That's how he got caught.
Because
he went, oh no, they're after me, and he tried to run away, and he ran around and right back into the people that were chasing him.
That's
the reason he was caught. Have you ever read the story of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde?
Yeah.
Really?
Long time ago.
Right.
I think when I was like 14, only because I was in New York and I was going to go see the play.
And did you?
Mm-hmm.
Was it the one when David Hasselhoff was playing Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde? He did that.
Where?
I think it was on Broadway.
No.
Yeah, Hasselhoff.
I definitely did not see it with him.
See, that's what I wanted to see. David Hasselhoff playing Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Like, I'm Dr. Jekyll. And then he would, through the miracle transformation, say, I'm Mr. Hyde. Because that's kind of...
Not as a joke?
Oh, yeah. No, he really did it. That's not a joke. No, don't go looking at them. It's not a joke.
Is there footage of this?
Yes, I'm sure we have.
Did you know I was on Baywatch with David Hasselhoff?
Well, you really, when you were... You must have been a kid.
I've been on Baywatch twice.
Right.
Once I was saving my classmate from drowning, and David Hasselhoff appeared. And then the second time, I was blind and lost in the forest, and then David Hasselhoff appeared.
What, you were lost in a forest in Baywatch?
Yeah.
What was the forest on the
beach? It was on fire.
The forest was on fire in the beach?
If I remember correctly. And then the episode ended with me boogie boarding in the ocean, but I'm blind.
But that would be heartwarming, though. Yeah, heartwarming. How do you do a blind acting now? See if you can do blind acting.
You're really good. I can see that. I can see how they cast.
How many people did I just offend within that 2 seconds?
You know, they well not blame people because they didn't see it. Yeah, so you're all right. No, I think that's fair to say. That is, you're not mocking people for being blind. You're not mocking. It's not. I mean, it's not a condition to mock.
I mean, I thought I did a really great job when I was 10 of being blind.
10?
Yeah. Well.
Are you frightened of David Hasselhoff when you were 10? He would be kind of like the Dr. Jekyll. He would be the horror monster to you, the giant hairy man running down the beach.
In little shorts.
Yeah. What was your... That was 10 years old when you did that?
Yeah.
You were a child actor?
I started when I was 9.
What did you do when you were 9?
Days of Our Lives. I played Young Hope. The first thing I did was a little movie called Piranha, Roger Corman's remake of Piranha.
Wait.
Not the original, that was in the 70s.
No, I'm talking, is that the one where...
with Soleil Moon Frye and William Catt?
And they shot it in Arizona or something?
No, I think we shot it in like Westlake Village.
Oh, okay. It looked a bit like Arizona. Piranhas in West... Are you frightened of piranha fish?
Well, I am now, but luckily I survived, so, you know, we're safe. I'll take care of the situation.
Were you blind?
No, I was vision capable.
All right. What are you going to do with the rest of your time in Edinburgh?
Buy some kilts. I feel like I talk about kilts a lot.
I think you're obsessed with it.
I bought a lot of candy yesterday. I don't think anybody realizes Cammie's and my friend Cammie and I went on an excursion for European candy. Because when you come back to the States, most people want candy, I've learned. We bought one of everything.
Right.
And then sometimes two of things.
And you ate them all. Now you have to go and buy them all
again. I only opened
a
couple of them. We just needed to try them out.
Right. The candy here is good though, right?
It's so good.
I know.
Like,
really good.
You guys have those airy things with the...
Arrows, yeah.
What? Why don't we have those?
Because the FAA are against it.
Because it's wild.
That's right.
The
Federal Aviation Administration are against
those darn
They don't want aviation and candy mixing. And putting air inside candy is something they will not stand for.
That's bad.
It's dangerous.
It's harmful to people and planes.
Yeah.
Totally. All right. This is delicious, you guys.
Yeah, you've had enough of them.
I don't know what you're trying to say.
It's an intervention is what I'm trying to say.
I knew this was a trick.
Yeah, it's all about this. We're worried about
it. Do you know why I can't really drink beer in real life?
Why? Which means this isn't real life. Because whatever you're doing right now, you're doing fine.
It makes me burp.
It's meant
to. I don't drink sodas for that reason. In public, I should say. It's weird because I literally can belch like a man.
Go.
No, I can't under pressure.
All right. But it's all right to belch. Even people say, I have had enough alcohol now. I'm not going to have any more because I'm beginning to feel it. I'm like, that's the point. You're meant to feel it. Keep going and feel it some
more. But beer is so heavy. Like, beer is like, you feel like you're eating a meal every single time you drink beer.
I know. It's awesome. I miss it.
Do you, though?
No.
Yeah, exactly.
A little bit.
It's kind of grody.
A little bit.
No.
Whiskey.
I had scotch yesterday. Did I tell you this experience?
No.
Well, I learned how to properly drink scotch. Apparently, I am not an aficionado of hard liquor.
Right.
So I like literally took it as a shot, and I was like, bleh, bleh. And the bartender was like,
no.
Yeah, they were like, no. And I went, what? That's gross. And they're like, that's because you're doing it wrong.
Right.
So then I put a couple drops of water, and then I sipped it. Kind of amazing.
You liked it?
I did. Mm. I did. I can't lie. I don't smoke cigarettes, but I could see
people... You will, sir.
The cigar thing.
By the
thing,
end of the day.
I'm like,
yeah,
up
you'll
and
be
away.
Smoking cigar. You'll probably be smoking a pipe and drinking whiskey by the end of the day and fighting.
No, I can't. I stopped smoking cigarettes like 6 months ago. So there will be no smoking.
All right.
But with the scotch and the whiskey, I can see how it's delicious.
No, it's great.
Yeah. Nice. Gosh, this is like a promo for an alcohol. I'm like, go drink alcohol, children.
All right. That's enough. That's enough. Go now.
I don't want to.
No, you have to.
But I want to.
You got something in your eye. Oh, I can see your glass eye thing. I can just see it. That's
what
it is.
You want me to move back?
Yeah.
Can you see it now?
I can just see it. There's a little bit of glass
right
in your
here.
Eye.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a bit of glass in your eye?
Yeah, it's a reflector.
That's like Deacon Brodie, maybe. That's how they caught him.
Do you think that it's...
It's really cool. Really cool. I wish I had one of those. Oh, like David Bowie's eyes. You know David Bowie's eyes?
Two different color eyes.
Yeah, that's... You know what that's called?
I used to have two different color
eyes. You know what that's called?
Mm.
Myxomatosis.
Mm-hmm.
That's actually not... Myxomatosis is a disease in rabbits.
Of?
Rabbits.
Just a rabbit disease.
No, rabbit.
A rabbit.
Like, no rabbits?
Yeah. What does the disease do?
It kills them. It's a deadly disease.
What's a rabbit look like again?
This.
Are these like the teeth or the whiskers?
That's his ears.
yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Your big skip.
It makes me happy. It makes me happy to skip out of the castle. I am the Queen of Scots. What I'm going to do is buy you girls the greatest fashionable outfits that you'll look swell in when you get back to California.
Great.
Well,
yeah.
Okay.
This is the place where you're going to get.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, there you go. Look, they've got girls' deluxe kilts. They're deluxe. That means they're better. All right.
Kilts galore!
Look, see this guy here? Look at this guy.
Schmancy.
Hey. Hey. He's pointing where you should go. Uh-huh. Go in there. Go in there. You girls try on outfits and I will judge you.
Okay.
Like a sugar
you're
daddy
gonna sit
sort
there?
Of thing.
Top model.
Mm, like top model. Yeah, I'm Tyra.
Wow, I want a knife.
And you're hopefuls.
Why couldn't I be Tyra?
I'm Tyra because you're the models. You are both much
but
more
I
attractive than me,
Tyra.
And I'm Tyra. No, I'm Tyra.
But I'll be Tyra.
What? You want to be Tyra? We can't all be Tyra. That's stupid.
I look the most like her. I'll be Tyra.
Oh, you know, I
don't know about that.
I don't think you look like Tyra. You maybe look like something Tyra would
I'm
eat.
I'm smiling
but
with
you...
my eyes.
Oh, that was mean.
No, that's a joke. See these different things here? These are called sporins. This is what they used to look like in the 1970s. And this is what they look like now. Do you
Why
see?
Why do you put them in the front? Like, how come you can't have, like, a satchel?
Well, because you need your hand free for your sword.
Wouldn't that hurt, like, if you're walking and it just keeps...
No, and you know what the rule is as well? When you're wearing it, when you're dancing with a lady, when you're wearing a kilt and you've got this thing...
You can't, like...
No, you move it to the side. That's the proper etiquette. And then you dance.
You don't want it to get, you know...
Right.
That sends the wrong message.
No, that's you move it to the side and then you send the wrong message. Girls, go and change into outfits and I will judge you.
Oh, I love being judged. It's my
this
favorite.
Is going to be great. I'm Tyra.
I'm Tyra.
I'm Tyra.
I'm Tyra.
Come on, let's see it.
Whoa, I almost fell.
Nice. Ariel Tweedle representing for Alaska. Very, very good. Ooh, super sexy, Kunis, but I think you both have to agree. I'm Tyra.
I'm Tyra.
No, I'm Tyra. Look at me. I'm gorgeous.
Wow.
I'm gorgeous. Stunning. And men want me. And ladies too. Don't do that. I really don't do that. Because, you know, stuff will happen. And I'm... Congratulations, you're no longer in the running to become America's Next Top Model. Please state your name for the folks at home, beginning with you.
Mila Kunis.
And?
Private Michael Clark Duncan, sir.
Right, and who are you?
Ariel Tweedo, sir.
Right, and what are you going to be doing here in the city of Edinburgh today? Ariel?
Drinking a beer.
Drinking a beer. Michael?
I'm loading these balls into the cannon, sir.
That's right, because this is Edinburgh Castle, where they shoot balls over the wall.
They shoot balls?
I did the ball joke already!
Sir, I didn't get the joke, sir.
I did the ball joke. I waited. You said the ball joke. You can let it go now, man. We did the ball joke.
No, I'm reporting for duty, sir. Awaiting orders, sir.
You talk to him. Every time I talk to him, he does that sir thing, and then
I don't want him to do it.
Well, just try and talk him off the ball joke thing.
No more ball jokes!
No more ball jokes!
Reporting for duty, sir!
He doesn't listen.
I will protect Edinburgh Castle with my life, sir!
Actually, you know what? If you had been here at the time, you would have been very popular.
I would have been good.
You would have been good.
Yeah, right?
The history of this island might be completely different.
I would have hollered out, Edinburgh Castle!
Oh, you know what? We should do the Braveheart thing. Get it out of the way.
Oh, all right,
all right. After three, everybody shout freedom, all right?
Okay.
All right, and then we'll go to a commercial. After three. One, two, three.
Freedom!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. It looks nice here, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Right. Let me tell you what happened here. One night when I was on what the kids call LSD. I was walking in this very spot, and I was attacked by killer ducks. The ducks in this pond attacked me. It was nothing to do with the drugs. I was coming back, it was late at night. And I was coming by and I heard this, I heard... Quack. And I was like... And then I heard... Quack. And I started to run. And they came after me. Imagine the zombie apocalypse, yeah, but with ducks.
I believe it totally, totally happened.
It really did happen.
These ducks look evil. Just look at them.
This is the mean streets of Glasgow.
Mean streets of Scotland.
Oh, man, that was hilarious and fun. But other than that, you know, don't do drugs.
That's true.
That's true.
Is it?
Yeah, yeah.
She stars in the film Jupiter Ascending, which is in theaters February the 6th. She doesn't really have her own fragrance.
No.
Well, maybe she does. Let's find out. It's Mila Kunis, everybody. Mila Kunis. What?
For all talk shows, you have to do pre-interviews. Like, they sit you on the phone and you talk about the things you're going to talk about. And then you come here and then this happens. And pre-interviews mean nothing on the show. It is my favorite show in the world to do.
Then... then I have some rather unpleasant news for you. Hey, I haven't seen you since Scotland. Anything going on in your life?
You know, a couple things here and
yeah,
there.
Yeah, congratulations. That's
thank
lovely.
You.
How old
thank
now?
You. 2 months.
No, you.
Oh, me.
No, it's a joke. 2 months,
well,
that's lovely.
Yeah, 9 weeks.
That's still good.
Yeah.
It's when they start
things.
Moving.
She's not lethargic. I mean, she moves.
No, it's when they start walking around the legs.
No,
and they're like, ah, like that. But it's a girl. You're fine. Girls are easy.
Yeah, I think so.
Until they're teenagers.
That's not my problem. That's daddy's problem.
Well.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think it'd be your problem, too.
You have boys, yeah?
Yeah, boys, yeah. Yeah,
that's,
boys.
It's different.
Yeah.
You know what, though? My sister-in-law had a little boy 2 weeks prior to us having our little girl, and it is completely different.
Yeah.
Everything.
Boys, so you're telling me men and women are different?
What?
Yeah.
No.
From the
get-go. Are you maybe onto something?
Yeah, no, from the very beginning, though.
Yeah, I do.
Like, from the very beginning, like my son is like drives cars around. Not real cars, obviously, but
yeah,
he has little cars, and I let him drive my car.
Do you?
Speed and a half.
Three, that's good, it's perfect. Thank
yeah. It's like, just don't go on the freeway.
I do remember when I was really little, though, I did sit on my dad's lap and like I thought I was driving, but I held the wheel. This isn't a whole other country where I'm sure in America it's very illegal, but I had the greatest time doing it and I have a great memory from
that,
it.
That was the country of...
Ukraine.
Oh, that's right, yeah. Soon to be known as...
Russia.
No, I think that's probably... It's probably illegal in the Ukraine as well, yeah.
Well, now, who knows? But back then, I think it was, fine.
Yeah, that was fine.
It was no
so, problem. Drive around, everything's all right.
Yeah.
Because everyone in Ukraine talks like Dracula.
By the way, that's my go-to accent for everyone, period.
Like, what, Dracula?
Yep, sure. Like, everyone, if you're from Spain, I'm like, they talk like these the whole time. And everyone's like, that's not Spanish accent. I'm like, yes, it is. Like, across the board.
Spanish Dracula would be good. Like, I don't often drink blood, but when I do, it's,
Dos Equis?
Dos Equis, of course. I don't know if we can say that. Can we say that? Oh, ooh la la! You, my friend, are a racist. That's what I'm telling you. So that's lovely. So you've had a baby and everything's
yeah.
going. You look great.
Thank
have you got
you.
A workout regime?
You know, it's called baby.
Yeah.
Breastfeeding is a great workout.
Oh, I have to say.
Yes. Oh, please.
Well, I don't have to say, but I'm going to say. When I miss my wife's breastfeeding.
Look.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's different.
It's spectacular.
Yeah. It's crazy.
It's like, what?
Can we talk about making this permanent? it's quite a thing.
I know. Yeah. Oh, I know. Yeah.
Do you get very tired when you're, you know?
Not too tired. I seem to eat a lot, so that kind of keeps me going through the day.
Yeah, that's what most people do.
Yeah, not
yeah, you'll
bad.
Be all right. Hey, I became a vegetarian.
What? Why? I mean, congratulations, but any specific reason?
Yeah, yes. I don't know. I've got friends who are from the animal kingdom, and it was a request made.
I think it's great. You know what? I'm not a vegetarian, but I do love to eat healthy. So if you ever need recommendations of really great vegetarian restaurants or vegan places.
You need them all the time because every time I go into a restaurant, I'm like, I guess I'll have fries.
No fish, nothing.
Not even cheese or eggs.
No dairy.
No, or cheese.
Do you feel better? What, cheese and dairy, two different things?
I do feel a bit better, actually.
Do
yeah.
You?
Yeah, I needed to lose a bit of weight because last time we were in Scotland, I was 400 pounds.
I mean, it's amazing.
400 pounds.
Is that how I remember?
Yeah, I was. I had to use a stick to change channel on TV. No, you know what? I was a fat kid. Were you a fat kid?
No.
See, I was a fat kid, and I think it makes you your whole life you're kind of
but
thinking about.
But you were never that fat. I mean, I don't remember.
Oh no, I was. My nickname was Tubby when I was a kid.
But so was mine.
I had
mine,
a party.
But...
Nobody came. Fatty had a party. Oh. Nobody came. Yeah.
I'm sorry. Oh yeah, there he goes.
Yeah.
Buy it, none of you.
No, it's all right. So things are going all right then.
Yeah, no complaints. I was able to take time off from work.
Where'd you go?
Nice. Nowhere. I went home. That is my version of time off. I spent all my 20s. It sounds crazy, but I did spend all my 20s traveling. And it's the greatest experience ever. And you get to see the world and you experience life and you meet people. And it's fantastic, but you don't have a home. And so when I decided to take time off, all I wanted to do was have the same bed to wake up in, a routine, a house, and it was great.
You've become very traditional and kind of, you know.
I love it.
I think
it's a luxury, though, to be able to do that. Like, I'm able to be a stay-at-home mom with my kid, and I do find that nowadays, people can't do that. Everyone has to have a job,
you
have to be a two-person household.
Yeah.
And so I was able to take time off and actually raise my child, which
for the last 2 months, anyway.
But I mean, for me, time off.
Yeah, yeah. No.
Two months for me.
When you go back to work, though, you take the baby with you.
Absolutely.
The baby goes and the baby has to, you know, are you going to raise the kid Scottish? Like, you know, chimney sweep at six.
And then what?
And then the sort of wing walking by the early teenage years.
Yeah.
And then jail.
Obviously. No jail?
No jail, no wing walking, but chimney work.
Chimney's good.
Yeah. I had a job when I was very young. I had a job. You had a job when you were... What age were you when you started?
I started acting when I was 9. But that didn't prevent my parents from making me do like things. Like, my mom would pick me up from 70 Show. She was working Rite Aid, which is like a drugstore in L.A. And she would...
Yeah, I think they know what Rite Aid is.
Well, not them, but there's some... Listen.
I have never been to your country before. What is this magical place full of things to put in your ears and your ass? Why? This Rite Aid is American. I don't know where am I going with his accent.
It's like partially Italian, partially.
It's
like
Italian Russian. Dracula, yeah. with a little bit of Clinton.
Yeah. There you go. It's really, with the hair, it works.
Yeah, I've got new hair.
I like it.
Peaky Blinders.
I like it. It's very, very nice.
I'm going
nice.
For aging Vanilla Ice.
Oh my God, that's
sweet. Oh my God. Ice, baby. Ice, baby.
I like it.
Yeah, so anyway, your mom would take you to Rite Aid?
Oh, yeah, so my mom would pick me up from 70 Show, and she couldn't go back home because she had to go back to work. So she would drag me to work with her, and I would work, like, the ice cream counter or the photo counter until closing. All the time.
And did people recognize you?
All the time.
Really?
Yeah. All the time. They were like, that's weird. Okay, can I get... And they kind of moved past it. And I was like, yes, okay. And, like, scoop their ice cream.
Did you ever get mixed up and then scoop ice cream where you shouldn't have on TV?
On TV?
Yeah. You know, on the 70s Show, did you ever go, that's all right, yeah.
I think everybody at 70s thought it was so weird that I was like, I gotta go to Rite Aid and work now, see you guys later. Like, it was weird, but it was great.
Yeah, I think it's good for you. Clearly, you're a well-adjusted human being as opposed to, you know...
Not.
What could have happened.
Yes.
You know.
Keep in mind, my parents, I don't know if I ever told you, my parents took away my car keys when I was 16. And
good for them. Yeah. I like them.
But then I had a job to go to, and they were like, too bad, so sad. So they left me like $1.25 and said, figure out the system. And I swear to God, I got up in the morning, I had to be at 70s, and I was like, ugh, how do I take the bus to work? And I had to go outside and figure out which bus went to where to get to the valley to go to work.
This is in L.A.?
Yeah. My parents were awesome.
And they actually said,
too bad, so sad.
This long story short, I did something wrong. Neither one of us can remember what I must have done. And they were like, we're taking away your car keys. And I was like, you can't do that. I have a real job. And then I woke up in the morning and my car keys were missing. And there was $1.25 on the table that said, here. And that was it. And then I had to go and figure out how to take
it. I think that's a great thing. I think they did a good job with you.
I agree.
So much so that I'm going to have a commercial now, and there's going to be one for Rite Aid. Maybe?
We're right back with Mila Kunis.
We're back.
Yes.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey. So we were talking about Scott. Last time I saw you was in Scotland.
Yes.
And you bought a kilt.
I did.
And I didn't know who you were buying the kilt for.
I know.
And it was for a special friend.
It was. And yeah. It turned out great because, you know, nothing's under the kilt. It's too soon? Too much?
Well, no, you can
it's
say that.
I can say this.
What, nothing's under the kilt? You don't wear anything? So Ashton doesn't wear anything?
Me.
I did say
nothing
that.
Nothing goes under the kilt. That's
right.
Apparently it's just, you know.
So does he walk around like.
He loves kilts.
Yeah?
Yeah. Well, I think the day that I landed when we were back from Scotland was on St. Paddy's Day.
Right.
And then we went out to like a bar and he wore his kilt and he, yeah, every St. Patrick's Day.
St. Patrick's Day is an Irish thing. You get that, right?
I there know, it's a kilt.
You know,
but
that's like, well,
kilt.
We landed in America at Canadian Thanksgiving, and it was just lovely.
I know, but it was...
We had maple syrup. Listen, it was awesome.
A Scottish kilt looks like an Irish... I mean, to most people, I'm sure, too. You know, not to offend. Oh, my God, I just offended somebody. I'm going to get some horrible
Oh,
email.
Don't worry. The minute you start talking on late-night television, you offend somebody. I found that out.
Really?
Yes.
How many people do you think you offend nightly?
Oh, well, I'd like to start with him. And then...
I feel like every time the camera pans to you, you're just shaking your head. Like, it doesn't even matter what it's for. It's just in sheer... It's just sheer disappointment.
But this is a character that Michael has adopted, clearly. He's a very cheerful, upbeat person who's not a racist at all.
I wish you could pan to him now.
Oh, no, he's been like that. So, there you are. We're out of time.
What?
Yeah, that's it.
How's that so fast?
I know. Well,
look at this. It says 00. Is that really true?
No. Yeah, that's the clock. Okay, says 00.
Your weird little robot's moving. That guy's so creepy. I have to tell you, no matter how many times I'm on the show, it's still weird.
You hear
less
that?
Weird than
what the hell, man?
Yeah. Why are you doing that?
I got feelings, too. What are you trying to do to me?
It's so weird. You kind of sound like Jim Carrey now. It's a little Jim Carrey-ish, no?
You think he sounds like Jim Carrey?
A little bit.
Jimmy.
It's so weird. I'm gonna miss it. It's great.
I know.
The horse that doesn't make any sense. It's just all so strange. Look at this.
It's not a real horse, Mila.
It's not?
No.
That's what do you mean?
Well, the front end's real. The back end's
yes, go on.
The back end, I think, is taking a break.
I know, that's the back end. Where's the back end?
The back end's like, yeah, what's going on? No, they won't need me for this, but it's all right.
Wait, he's in. Okay, no, we're safe. Right. We're good.
Anyway, we're done. Awkward pause for old time's sake?
Yes, let's do it.
Okay.
Wait, you know what? For old time's sake. Here we go.
Oh, your special cup.
I made it for you, but you seem to have forgotten it. Look how beautiful this cup was that I made.
It's lovely, but I didn't want to use it in case it got broken.
Yeah, right. You're so full of...
Uh-oh.
Okay, awkward pause.
Awkward pause.
Here we go.
What I'm enjoying is that the audience is having a harder time of this than we are. Mila Kunis, everybody.